Okay, let me just put on my armor before I start this bad boy. Let me just... Yep, and okay. Yep. Okay, now I know we're living in a period where saying this movie wasn't made for me is an evil hex words because of... But I only think that's fair to acknowledge going into this review.
So,
yeah, okay, yeah, no, that's it. No, we're done. Well, okay, actually, wait, one thing, though. People keep comparing this movie to Superbad, and it's hard not to. They're both coming-of-age, end-of-high-school comedies where people get laid and talk about sex and face the future. Plus, you know, it's one of those things that has a very specific connection to another thing, and it's impossible not to bring up and then use as a justification to associate the two. That said, given the tone of this movie, I think it's really hard to make a meaningful comparison between Superbad and Booksmart. I think people underestimate tone as a differentiating factor between movies. Even if plot and characters are similar, like, really similar, there are still other things that make movies different movies, you feel? And I feel like Superbad and Booksmart are in two different enough camps that they shouldn't be compared. Except like I did just now 1 minute into my video, and in the title of this video probably, please subscribe, I'm an academic and I know what I'm talking about. Quote my ideas to your friends and they'll think you're good at movies. I like Booksmart a lot, but it totally feels like a directorial debut, and not always in the best ways. Like, okay, some debuts have the awkward idiosyncrasies of a first try, but use them to create some unique character out of the imperfections. Olivia Wilde made a mean first impression, but I'd be lying to you if I said it didn't feel a little scatterbrained in all of the wildness of the movie, and I don't know why I made a pun there, because that's an actually important point I want to make. I blame the genre, though. I think the movie comedy as a genre has a lot of dangerous pitfalls given its structure, and it can lead to some old problems coming up again and again. I mentioned this in my review of A Quiet Place, a great important video about a movie that was fine. I think that a lot of horror movies, especially the more schlocky ones, can break down to a bunch of spooky sequences based around the premise that can ultimately feel kind of cheap. I think comedies, even good ones, get trapped in that too, and it can cause problems, but it doesn't have to. Take the Monty Pythons. Holy Grail, despite having a plot of some kind, sort of knowingly dissolves it in favor of doing a series of period-based silly night sketches. And it works. It really works, duh. But then you have Life of Brian, which takes a less ensemble-based, more narrative-driven approach, and it also works great. You could even make an arbitrary, totally subjective scale to organize movies from sequence-based to plot-oriented, but that would be confusing and superfluous, so here it is. It is possible for great things to come out of both ends, but I think the tackier comedies tend to sit on this side of the fence. And Booksmart and Superbad go here-ish? Here-ish and here-ish? Maybe? Did I just compare them again? F it. If done well, it should be hard to notice how sequence-based a movie is, but this is where the directorial debut thing comes into focus and really draws attention to the fragmentation of the sequences. It, at times, just feels like a bunch of detours invented to create silly scenarios, which doesn't always make for excellent plot progression, which draws attention to the directorial debut thing, which, you know, so on. It just got me thinking about comedy structure is all. Besides that, though, the lead's chemistry felt fresh, and there were well-executed efforts used to subvert the very specific coming-of-age high school sex trip across town one degree from Jonah Hill comedy genre. But like A Quiet Place, it feels a little trapped in its structure, and yes, that's right, you can't compare Booksmart to Superbad, but you can compare it to A Quiet Place, random internet movie boy said. All of that in mind, Booksmart was heck of fun, and I want more wildness. That was where the pun should have gone, goddammit. See it, learn from it. Quote the smart things I said here to your friends, make them think that your opinion is the correct one in the group, tell them that John Wick really isn't that good and A24 horror movies are the only reason you're still on this earth, start a YouTube channel, post once a month, they'll love it, post once every 2 months, they'll love it, keep going, you're doing great, you're doing great. Alright, thanks for watching.